Hello friends, myself Rakesh. Today we are going to discuss about the process transaction. So let me show you what we are going to achieve. Let me show you the goal of this RE framework. So this is the Excel file. From this Excel file, I would like to calculate shared hosting fee and late fee. So I want to upload all these data to orchestrate a queue. And then I wanted to sum this two up. Okay, so for example, if I calculate this two, the total amount is somewhere like 89,600. Okay, so this is what I wanted to do it through RE framework. Okay, this is your input file. From this input file, it should read the entire file, upload the data to orchestrator, queue item, and from the queue item, I would like to sum these two values and show the total amount due. So let's see how to do it. So this is the goal. Keeping this goal in mind, we have to go through init, get transaction data, then process transaction data. So click on init, and inside init, scroll down, and you will find something called invoke init all applications workflow. Okay, we are initializing all the applications. So I have to read my Excel file. So I'll be designing that workflow over here. Click on open workflow. Now here I have designed the workflow to save time. So I have taken an Excel application scope and given the path, and then I'm using a read range, the path of the file, then read range activity. And here it will read that entire Excel file. So the entire Excel file will be read, and then it is going to store in a data table called PDFDT. Clear? So this is my data table. Now I am using a for each row activity, using the PDF DT data table, which will go through each row item one by one. So when it reads for the first time, it will read this entire row, then it will read the second, third, fourth, like this. All the data will be read from this Excel file. So once it reads, I want to upload this data to the queue. Okay, so let's see the queue. Type platform.uipath.com and click on services, open your service. So all of this I have taught in my orchestrator video, you can see that, or else you can follow the previous chapters that I have covered on RE framework. Once you are in the home page, click on queue, and here you have to click on the plus sign and simply give a name. So let me give Expo Hub demo queue. Okay, so this is my queue name, and click on add. So all this you don't have to worry about, just leave as is, click on add. Okay, so once your queue is created, go back to UiPath. Now let's focus on the add queue item. Here you have the queue name, right? So your queue name should exactly match with your queue created in the UiPath platform.uipath.com. Okay, in the orchestrator we have created the queue, it should match. And then the very critical thing is your collection, the data that you want to upload. I don't want the entire Excel to get uploaded, right? So I will choose which data. So here is the item information collection, click on this. Here I am choosing to only upload three data: name, shared hosting fee, late fee. So these are the three data: name, shared hosting fee, and late fee. I want to only upload these three data because this is the three data I want to process in this project. Okay, so what I am doing, I have created an argument called inName, and then here the value what I am doing, row. So I am running a for each loop, right? So row in bracket build to name. This build to name is coming from your Excel file. Okay, exact name you have to copy this and then paste it over here. Build to name dot to string. Same thing you have to do for all the other two data. Okay, for all the other two data, I am doing row shared hosting fee, row late fee. So all of the data will get uploaded into the orchestrator. Okay, so this I have made it very clear in the previous chapter. In case you want to see that, you can go ahead and look the RE framework previous chapters. Okay, so in this area, I have uploaded the data. So let me go back to main Okay, now comes to the get transaction data. So in the get transaction data is nothing but downloading that data from the queue. Okay, so this is your queue. So once we run it, the data will get uploaded over here and we can see all the data. I will show you that. And in the get transaction data, I am going to download the required data and process them in the project's process transaction state. So let's see, I am going to explain it. Now in the get transaction data, double click, and here on the right hand side you have the invoke get transaction data where you have to concentrate in detail. Again, there is a chapter on this one. I have it is there on my video section, you can check that. So here what you do, click on open workflow. Okay, here the get transaction item, you should, this is very critical. Now get transaction item downloading all the data into out transaction item. So this is the argument where all my data from the queue will get downloaded, all the data whatever I have uploaded, all the data will get downloaded here into out transaction. But I want to process only specific data, I am going to show you. So here all the data has been downloaded. Now let's go back to main. Now in the main we are coming into the next state called process transaction. This is what our topic today. So process transaction, what I have to do, you have to, as I always said, before you get into any kind of workflow, reading the arguments is very, very critical. Because if we don't have understanding of the arguments, then you will not be able to understand that workflow. So click on imports argument, and here you will find the transaction, our data was in the out underscore transaction item, right? But if you see it here, there is no outdoor transaction. So how the data would come from that state to this state? Let's see that. To see that, go back to get transaction data, and here you have this import argument. Click on this import arguments, and here you will see outdoor transaction data, right? Transaction item. So this is the data, you know, this is the data which will have all the downloaded data from the get transaction item activity. So all the data will be here. So what it is doing, the data will be passed from this direction. Okay, from this it will come to transaction item. So this is a new argument or new variable which is will be used in the processing transaction state. Okay, in the next state it will be used. So remember, this is very critical to understand. So get transaction data will put download all the value into this variable or argument, and then this data is a out direction, so this value will be passed to the new variable called transaction item. Okay, so there is a new variable called transaction item, we need to remember. So the value of get transaction item passed to a new argument called transaction item. Okay, so this you should remember. This exactly happens in the state 2. Okay, so after that we will get into the process state. Okay, now process state is state 3. Now I am entering the process transaction. So here if you see what they are doing, the transaction item, the new data, again passing its value from this direction, and it's coming to the new variable called in underscore transaction item. Okay, so this you should remember, in underscore transaction item is the new variable which has the data. So let me get into the workflow. So the process transaction workflow is completely blank. So first thing I want to understand, let me see the values. Okay, so message box I will use, and I would like to see the value one by one. So to do that, what I will do for the moment, let, because it has not uploaded any data, so I have to run it. But I know all my values will be there in underscore transaction item. So if I want to see something, some specific data, so I have to say specific content. Okay, and the variable. So how do you know the variable, which where exactly? So what you do, you simply go back to main. So where you are uploading data, add queue item, right? Go there, go to init, and oh, scroll down, and you have this init where you are using the add queue item, right? So go here. Here the add queue item, right? So this is very important to know, make a note of these names. So your first name is in underscore name, okay? Second one is in underscore shared hosting fee. Third one is in late fee. So exactly the same value you have to type, okay? In underscore name. So let me first show you the in underscore name, then we will process all of this data. Okay, so now I am in the process transaction state and I am inside that workflow. So here what I'm doing, in underscore transaction item dot specific content, and here I'm writing the data in underscore, I'll show you this, what in case you are not understanding here, I am going to show the demo dot toString. Okay, so let me do one thing, let me run this now, then we will understand in very nicely. So let me, so before you run it, save everything, all the changes that you have done, go to the main and then run it. So our first data has come, Rahul Jignesh. So I'm just pulling this name, okay? Then our next data should be Nagesh Reddy. Third data should be, so same way I can pull all of this items one by one. Rohan Verma and then Joydeep Sahu. This is the last name, okay? So now the process is complete. Now let us understand in detail. So what is happening, let me go to the main, let me show you. So here we have uploaded the data, right? So here we went to init, then we went to the workflow called invoke init all application. We opened this workflow, and inside this workflow we read the Excel file, we created a data table, and then we run a for each loop, and then we have using the add queue item and uploading the data using the item information collection with three of these arguments. So these three arguments, let me go to orchestrator and see the data. So in the orchestrator, this is the export demo queue. Click on this one and click on view transactions. So here these are the data, right? So when you open this view details, so you will see the add queue item with this following variables, it has uploaded the data. Okay, in late fee, so whatever you have declared, in the same way it has uploaded the data in the first in first out format, it has uploaded each of this data. So let's say, because I have to sum these two numbers, right, this one and this one, so how to do that, let's see it. So to add those two values, go to process transactions, and here in the process transaction, click on this workflow. So just now we saw how to, you know, see the data. So this time I saw the in name. So what I want, my job is to add two values. So what I will do, I'll use a assign activity, and here let me create a variable, control K. So there are two values. One is shared hosting fee, right? Let me show you the Excel file. So shared hosting fee is one value. This one, late fee, is another value. And the same thing is there in my orchestrator, right? In the queue it is there, in shared hosting fee, in late fee. So these two values I have to add. So to do that, I'll go to the assign activity and declare a variable, and here I want to get that specific item, right? So I know all my data is now in underscore transaction item dot specific content. So let me show you in a bigger screen. Okay, so the variable which contains all the data from the orchestrator queue is this variable dot specific content, and which content you want. So first content that I want is, so you should be very careful writing this, okay, because it's small and it's case sensitive. If it is a small mistake, then it won't fetch the value. So go back to your orchestrator, and I need this variable, right? So copy this and paste it over here. Okay, that is the exact name. Then, so this data, because they all have been uploaded as a string, right? So I want to convert that to integer. To do that, go to home and here you write c int, convert integer. Okay, c int means convert integer, and then put a bracket. Okay, so that way it's going to convert that string variable, string value, to integer value. Okay, so now the sh fee, this variable also should be a integer type. So all you do is go here, convert this to an integer type. Okay, so the error is gone. Same way you have to do it for the other value. So the other value is what? Late fee, right? So control plus k, I'm giving another variable called l fee. Okay, and here what you do, instead of shared hosting fee, delete this, go back to orchestrator and exactly double click on that, get that and paste it over here. Understood? This way it is going to pull that data, and then it is going to convert that to integer value, and it's going to store it here. Again, go to the variable and your LF is supposed to be integer type. Okay, so I've converted both of these values. Now I have to add it. So to add it, again copy paste the upper one and create a new variable here. So the new variable, control plus k, let's say total due, right? Total due amount. So total due, I have created a variable. And here what I will do, delete the previous one, and here I have to add these two variables. That's simple. SH fee, this is a integer type, sorry, SH fee is an integer variable, plus L fee, this is also integer variable. So that way both the data will be added and the sum value will be kept over here. Again, go to variable, total due supposed to remain integer 32. Okay, so this we have understood. All right, so let's see if it is working or not. For that, let's use a message box. Okay, and here I would say total due dot toString. Clear? Now let's save it. And always go to the main, okay? Do not run it from here. Then let's run it. Okay, so the first value has come, 89,600. Let me go back to the Excel, just see if the value is correct or not. These two values it is adding. So my value is 89,600, which is perfect. The second value, 26,178. So this two sum, if I do a sum of these two, 26,178. So you can see it is properly adding both the values and showing me the result. Okay, so you can see that. So all the values have come properly. Now what I want to do, let me go to process transaction. So instead of showing it a message box, what if I add to a data table, so that the data table I can add it to an Excel file or something like that, right? So to do that, what I will do, I'll go to this workflow once again in the process state, process transaction state. So here, instead of a message box, what I will do, I wanted to add that to a data table. So adding it to a data table is very handy, right? You can do anything with that. So what I will do, I'll go to build data table activities, simply type data table. Okay, now here in the data table, there is something called build data table. So drag and drop this activity, click on data table, and here, you know, remove the default ones, click on the plus sign, and here I want to create a data table, total due amount. Okay, this is the column name, and this is supposed to contain integer type data. Click OK. Done. So my data table is created. Now give a name to your data table. So control plus K, and here I will give total amount due DT. Okay, So this is my this has become a long data table. That's fine. Total amount due DT. So this is my data table I have created. Okay, now I wanted to, because every time this runs for each transaction, right? So it will go, it will process the first transaction, show the value, then again it will pick the next value, show the transaction, right? So it is rotating, you know, one by one. If you go to the main workflow, you have seen when it is success, then it's going back again, right? Going back again to the get transaction data. Again, it's pulling the next data. So that way the loop is running, right? This you need to understand, the loop is running. So what I want, every time the loop runs, right, everything, so it has to add the data to the data table. So for that, what I will do, I'll use the next activity called add data row. Okay, so this is the next activity. Now in the add data row, what I'm going to do, I will mention the data table name. What is the data table name I have created? Total amount due. So again, go here, write total amount due data table. Okay, so here it should, in this data table, it should add the values that are coming here. So which value? The total due amount should add it here. So for to do that, go to array row, then give curly braces. Here you say total, and should be exactly correct. Okay, total due. Okay, so the spelling should be exactly the same way, total due. So this is the value, this is the variable which will have the total value, and it should add it to the data table. That's all. Okay, so done. So I've added to the data table. Let's say I want to see what is the value. For that, you have to scroll down, and there is something called output data table. So this will convert the value to text and you can see it. So output data table, what I will do, let me, the input data table for this one is this one, right? What we have built, total amount due. Go here, and in the data table, say total amount due, where you have to read the data from. And once you read the data, you store the data into a text variable, control plus. Okay, let me give a variable called output. Okay, so output variable will have the data now. So if I want to see that text variable, again use a message box. Now in the message box, simply say output variable. So that way, so let me explain. First, we have added both the values, SH fee, late fee, and that value comes to total due. Then we simply built a data table, total amount DT, and in that data table, using add data row activity, we are adding the value. Which value? Total due. This variable value we are adding, and once we add, we want to see that. To see that, I am using the output data table activity. Okay, here I have mentioned the data table, input data table as the previous data table what we have created, total amount DT, and then the output into a text variable called output. That's all, guys. So here the message box will come in the output. So let's run it. So before you do it, as I say, save it, go to the main. Okay, then run it from the main. So this time again, what will happen, let me show you in the orchestrator what is happening. Okay, so in the orchestrator, you can see all the data has been processed, which the state has changed to successful. So we have run already two times. So all the data is successful now. So let me go back to the queue. Okay, so there is no data. So let me run it again. Now again, it is 10. Once we run it again, all the 5 data from the Excel file will be run, and that will become 15. So let's run it. Okay, so the first value has come, 89,600, which is correct. We have seen it last time. Okay, 89,600. So that is correct. Second one, 26,178, which is again correct. The same way, it is going to add all the values one by one. So this time we are not extracting the data using a message box, but rather we are using a data table and then trying to get the value. So the data table we can utilize anywhere in our project later state. Okay, so you understood this particular state, process state, how it can be executed, and depending on your project, you can go ahead and modify and add other workflows that you need depending on the project. But you understood the use of process transaction and the key variables which are required. So understanding the key variables is very, very critical. variables or arguments. Okay, so this time we have seen how the value is coming. Now after this, after all the transaction is done, then it is going to, you know, move to get transaction. There is no data, then it is going to end process. So in end process, let me show you end process, because I don't want to cover another chapter on this one, because this is simple. This has only one workflow: invoke close all applications. So if you click on open workflow, right, so it has got nothing apart from logging a message. So in case you want to close any application, so you have this, just type close, close workbook, close applications, close tab, close window. So all of this you can utilize over here. So depending on your project, so this time we don't require in this demo, but again, depending on your project, whatever is required, you have to, you know, use all this kind of, you know, activities. You want to close or kill, whatever activity. So not necessarily only close, and also use a kill process or whatever you want to do. Depending on that, you can utilize all of this activity in the end state. Okay, so with that, guys, we have covered the entire chapter of RE framework, and going forward we'll come up with, you know, small to complex or simple to complex examples of using RE framework. I'll come up with more examples. In case you have something in your mind, you can let me know. Okay, and let me know as to any project that you want to put it in a RE framework, and then wanted to see that how it runs. So we can probably create a demo out of one of the discussion that you guys wanted to comment. Okay, so we are going to come up with examples of using RE framework. So this itself is a good example, you have understood, but again, we'll come up with more examples, practical examples, to see it. So guys, please do like and comment your questions. Okay, so I want to see more likes and comments coming, so that one thing is, it motivates us. We know people are reading and people are understanding and giving benefit to other people. That way it motivates a lot. Please do not forget to hit on the like and comment your questions or anything you felt. Please do comment. Thank you very much, guys, for watching this. You guys have a wonderful day.